Hey, what's up everyone? This is Brian and welcome to Beginning Programming with CSharp. This is the first course in a three-part series that aims to take you, if you have some programming experience or even no experience at all, and turn you into a CSharp rock star. Okay, well, maybe not a rock star, but at the end of these three courses, you'll know how to read and write CSharp code. CSharp is Microsoft's flagship programming language that you can use to develop to program applications, develop back-end server components, or even create your own games. The fact that this language is used in a variety of different ways shows you how versatile and capable of a language it is. Now, before we dive into the particulars of what is covered in this course, let's take a step back and see how the language has actually developed. And to do that, we need to go all the way back to the 90s when a company called Sun had just wowed the computer landscape. After 5 years of internal development, Sun Microsystems introduced the Java programming language to the world. This language was originally designed for interactive television, but after that project crashed and burned, Sun retooled the language to be a general purpose application programming language. The idea was that you wrote and compiled the program once and it would work on all the platforms that supported Java. Now, previous to that, you had to compile a program for each individual platform, and each platform itself brought its own problems, and Java aimed to get rid of that. Now, it didn't work exactly like that. In fact, the saying write once, run everywhere became write once, test everywhere. In any case, it captured the attention of Microsoft, who wanted to provide a better integration with Java to the Windows platform. To use Microsoft features meant specifically targeting the Windows platform, which created incompatibilities with other Java implementation. Sun sued Microsoft and won, which caused Microsoft to actually remove the Java runtime. But Microsoft was hooked. The language inspired them to create their own managed language, which they actually called Cool, which really stood for C like object-oriented language. It was a pretty lame name. Starting in 1999, they spent the next 3 years designing the language and supporting frameworks, which they named .NET. The language was eventually called C#, and in 2002, it was released to the general public. Now, at first, the language looked pretty much like another version of Java, but in the subsequent years, it has grown into its own. Okay, so in this course, you'll learn the very basics of writing C# programs. In this first part, you'll learn how to install Visual Studio and learn about the basic building blocks of programs. You'll learn about variables and operators and so forth. Next, you'll learn how to have your programs branched based on the data it is storing. You'll learn about loops, if statements, and various things in between. By the time you finish this beginner course, you'll have a strong foundation to approach the two other courses. As you can see, we have a lot of ground to cover to get you up and running with C#. Every journey starts with the first step, and in the next episode, we'll take that step by downloading and install Visual Studio. Let's get started. C# is an exciting language that allows you to develop games to server applications. And guess what? You're getting the complete course here free on YouTube. So hit that subscribe button to be notified of new videos when they come out.